Hello, hello, welcome back to our channel. If this is your first time, please like, share, and subscribe. Our returning subscribers will love you. Thank you.
Question. our Heavenly Father calls his children pain. He just, that pain is not the pain that will be present. He will never allow that which you cannot handle to be for you. But that pain is for him to know how strong your faith is, how good you are, how strong you are in faith, how much you love him. That is why he allows those things to happen to us as Christians. He wants to know how much you care about his will, how much you care about his kingdom, how much you love him, because he has first loved you and I, and sent his only begotten Son to come and die for you and I. Now, in return, he wants to know, how did you appreciate that love? Praise God. How did you appreciate that love he has shown to you? That is why he allowed trials to come to us. He allowed us to fall into temptation. He wants to know if we will still stick with him. Praise God. If we will say, if God is like this, then I'm better off with my people. I'm still enjoying this till the end of time. That is why our Heavenly Father allows us to feel the pain, to suffer tribulation, to fall into all diverse of temptation, because he wants to know if we really love him in return. Praise God. Without temptation, without tribulation, without trials, there is no testimony, there is no victory, there is no greatness. Nothing would come easily in life. Be in the world or otherwise. Before you can be born to say, I am a child of God, the amount of trial you have handled in life is how powerful your faith is. You cannot say you belong to God and you hear a gunshot say, I'm no longer a Christian. It happened in the north before the coronavirus. When they now the full and the enter into the church and begin to ask people, if you are a Christian this way, if you are a Muslim this way. Everybody that was able to say was strong people that we know they are strong Christians, they joined the side of Muslim for the moment to die. Praise God. Those are trials. But they failed the test. Praise God. They failed the test. They fall into the temptation. They did not pass the test. One of them was trying to know how strong, what is their faith, what are they believing on. But they failed it. It was very few that stand in Christ and said, even till death, I am for God. Praise God, Pastor Jesus. Trials can come in any way. When you look at the life of the Hebrews, when they said, when you did not renounce your God, they are trying you into the furnace of fire. That was their trial, because they were believers. But the sister has said, even in death, I will not renounce my God. God knows that they are his children, but he did not take them away from them. He wants to know how much they can endure. God wants to know how much they can stand. How strong is their love? How strong is their faith in him? He lived them to the last moment, but our hope is never late. It's always on time. Before they get getting into the flame of fire, the angels of heaven is already there waiting for them. Praise Master Jesus. What am I trying to say? Don't see the pains. Don't see the trial as a problem, as a don't give up. Because if you did not give up, God will not give up on you. If you did not give up, no matter what you are facing, if you did not give into it, God will not allow you to suffer in vain. Even when Job lost everything he had during his trial, but at the end of it all, he gave them back in a double fold, except the children, but he still had them back. The place of the place, he gave them back in triple fold. Our God is not a God of confusion. caring father. He's a caring father. He allowed those things to happen to you and I so that we will know how great he is. How powerful his love is. Say who the father loves. You can be able to face a greater thing. Because the very moment you agree to serve God, the very moment you tell the world, and I'm no longer with you, I'm not in Christ, that is the very moment the world will face you. But God will send trials to you to know if really you can be able to face tribulation of the world. Praise God. When you will not be able to face of our Heavenly Father, how then can you be able to face the world? Temptation that came from the devil. Because when the devil is coming, he's not coming to you, he's coming with all three forms. But it not depend on how great your power is, how great you are in God, how your faith is. Because the Bible says, as little you as the mustard seed, if you add as a faith, you can be able to move mountains. What are the mountains and the tribulations that come from the world? Praise God. Are the trials that come from the world? How the pain that the world can inflict in you, you can be able to withstand it. As a Christian, I will leave you with this. As a Christian, God allows temptation, allows trials, allows pains to come to you. To destroy you, but rather to make you strong in faith. So, God allow temptation, tribulation, trial to happen in your life, to take place in your life, so that you can be able to build up your faith. That is the only way. A lot of people, when they are not passing temptation, when they are not facing tribulation, they don't remember that God is there. They don't pray. And what is God supposed to do?